All praise and honor and glory to Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Lakaha Kadash, and the Bahana Zelda, and the apostles of great ministry on the world, a peace, a blessing, and salutation to you, Akiam, who are pushing these truths, the four winds of the heaven, and be on the forefront of this spiritual war, and to make sure Jerusalem is established as a praise, and he only is again, as in the days of old. So this is in Psalm, the 86th chapter, man. A prayer of David. You see, so I'll start again. We see asking the Lord, man, please, Yahaba Hashem Yahshai, which is Babakasha, Yahaba Hashem Yahshai, hear our prayer. You see, so I will go into the Psalm 86, man, as a prayer of Matthew, man. See, so I started verse 1 and say, a prayer of David, bow down thy ear, O Lord, Yahaba Hashem Yahshai, hear me, for I am poor and needy. See? This is as a elect, man, poor and needy. See, let me see. I will go into the book of Matthew. See, this is the book of Matthew 5, and she said, blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. See, blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. So, why are the elect mourning, man? For various reasons, man. Starting with a spiritual and a physical reason, man. See, over here, we are trying to do our best so that our name can be written in the tree of life, and you have people trying to sow discourse. You have people trying to lead the sheep astray, man. That's the speech of accession, if you really think about it. Today I was meditating about people, man. Really, this leader, man, this whom we call grievous wolves, man. A grievous wolf. Which come among the sheep and confuse the sheep, because a sheep doesn't know anything, man. See? A sheep doesn't know anything. See? So, for younger brothers, let me say that for younger brothers, people who are new to this truth, really brothers who are new to this truth, man, who might be of the hopeful electing, see? If you come in a time period like now, you come with all this confusion which is going on. It's not really confusion, it's the spirit for Yahaba Hashem Yahshai. This is how Yahaba Hashem Yahshai move, man. But on the other side, this is very wicked, man. See? A scene of leading the sheep of Yahaba Hashem Yahshai astray, man. See? That's a very wicked deed like that, man. See? So the elect are afflicted in both side, man, both spiritually and physically. Here you have people of our nation, man, trying to sow discourse and everything. On the other hand, you have Esau, man. See? Everything in Esau's world is unclean. On the other hand, you have Eve. See? So it is the world against the electing. That's why the scripture tell you, preserve my soul, for I am whole, although my power, save thy servant that trust in thee. Be merciful unto me, O Lord, for I cry unto thee daily. See? So let's go to the book of Isaiah 14:1. It says, for the Lord Abba Hashem Hashem will have mercy on Jacob, that was going to the elect, and they will yet choose Israel, and they set them in their own land, and the stranger shall be joined with them, and they shall cleave to the house of Jacob. Say, be merciful unto me, O Lord, for I cry unto thee daily. That's what you are doing, man. There is a time period, man. There was a time period in which, let's see. I was going through something, and the only thing I was praying is, Yahaba Hashem Yahshai, please don't kill me, man. See? 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 That's what the scriptures was going to, for I cry unto thee daily. The joy is the soul of thy servant, for unto thee, O Lord, Yahweh Hashem and Shai, do I lift up my soul. For thou, Lord, art good and led to forgive. See? And appoint us in mercy unto them that call upon thee. Give ear, O Lord, unto my prayer. Let's go to the book of Daniel, book of Daniel 9. You see? The book of Daniel 9:9 said, to the Lord Yahweh Hashem and Shai, power belong mercies and forgiveness, though we have rebelled against him, neither have we obeyed the voice of our Lord Yahweh Hashem and Shai, power to walk in his laws, which he set before us by his servant the prophet. Yea, all Israel have transgressed the law, even the prophet, man. See, you might be asking yourself, when did the prophet transgresses the law? Because every time you read in the Bible, the prophet were going against two said men, always. So how then always have transgressed the law? Through your many incarnation, when we lost our identity, there was no prophet in the nation of Israel, but we keep coming again through the process known as regeneration. See? In your past life, you have committed sin, you are punishable by death, man. That's why the scripture tells you, all Israel have transgressed the law, even Jeremiah, man. That's why Jeremiah, the Lord told Jeremiah, even you will discontinue from your heritage. Why? Because the Lord knew, see, Jeremiah will come back through many incarnations and commit sins. That's why, see, he was subject into being discontinued from his heritage, even King David. So when you go to Deuteronomy 28, the scripture tell you, I think it is 36 or whatever, see, even your king will go into captivity. How many kings do we have in Israel? Yehoshai, starting with Yehoshai and King David. Yehoshai, see, of course, Yehoshai lived under the Roman ruler, but King David went to captivity. We're talking about King Mashai, if you can deceive that, man. See? Give ear, O Lord, Yahweh Hashem and Shai, to my prayer, and attend to the voice of my supplication. In the day of my trouble, I will call upon thee. So what I am trying to tell you, there is certainly time period in your life. I don't know if you have gone through this, but a lot of brothers have gone through this. You might encounter certain problem, and all you have to say is, please, Yahweh Hashem and Shai, don't kill me. You can't go for help to a brother, to the apostle, to the bishop, to the deacon. You can't go to your neighbor, to your father, your wife, or your sister. All you have left is the name of Yahweh Hashem and Shai. And that is a prelude to Jacob's trouble. If you can get that, man. The trouble you are going through right now are meant to fortify our mind, to build our character. Because in Jacob's trouble, this little moment you're going through, where are you? The only thing you have left is the name of Yahweh Hashem and Shai. It will be like that throughout Jacob's trouble, man. See, he said, in the day of my trouble, I will call upon thee. The scripture didn't say, I will call on my aunt, I will call on my apostle, I will call on the deacon, I will call on the brother next door, or the brother after camp, I'll call on that brother so that he can solve my problem. No, in that day of my trouble, I will call upon thee, for thou will answer me among the gods. There is none like unto thee. That's going to idly, see. O Lord, Yahweh Hashem and Shai, neither are there any work like unto thy work. All nation whom thou hast made shall come and worship before thee. O Lord, Yahweh Hashem and Shai, and shall glory thy name. See thy name. See, for Zoat greet and does wondrous thing, Zoat the power alone. Teach me thy way. That's a contrite spirit, man. See, that's contrition like there. Teach me thy way, O Lord, Yahweh Hashem and Shai, I will walk in thy truth, unite my heart to fear thy name. See? The fear of the Lord, man. See? Let me see. You see, the fear of the Lord is the first step to be accepted to whom and wisdom obtain his love. The fear of the Lord, this is Ecclesiastes 19:18, Ecclesiastes 19:20, the fear of the Lord is all wisdom, and in all wisdom is the performance of the law and the knowledge of his omnipotency. So going back to Psalm 86, see 11, teach me thy way. How is the Lord teaching his way? Through his fear. If you fear his, if you fear the Lord by following the Lord's statutes and commandments to the best of your ability, and you ultimately fear Yahweh Hashem Yahshai, he will teach you the way to omnipotence. He will teach you the way to the tree of life. Or Yahweh Hashem Yahshai, I will walk in thy truth. See? Unite my heart to fear thy name. So you don't just fear the Lord. You decide, let me fear the Lord today. Do you see the skull? This group that is known as Dagger Men, man. It's not like they don't fear the Lord. They don't have that ability because the Lord have to put fear in you so that you can fear him back. Do you think a scoffer don't fear the Lord? See? It is impossible for him to fear the Lord because it is not in him. Like faith. Faith should be in you first. That's why the scripture tells you faith is a gift. The fear of the Lord also is a gift. There are certain men known as the elect who were created to have the fear of the Lord. You see, and you, a few women out of them, I will praise thee, O Lord, Yahweh Hashem, Yahshai, thy power with all my heart, and I will glorify thy name forevermore. For great is thy mercy toward me, and so has delivered my soul from the lowest hell. And this is a card light here for you, Christian. Man, how many types of hell are there? Say, O Yahweh, the proud are risen against me, and the assembly of violent men have sought after my soul, and have not set thee before them. But thou, O Lord, art a power full of compassion, see, and a gracious, long-suffering, painters in mess and a truth, O turn unto me and have mercy upon me. Give thy strength unto thy servant and save the son of thy handmaid. All praise to Yahweh Hashem Yahshai, Babakasha, Babakasha, Babakasha. He says, show me a token for good, that they which hate me may see it and be ashamed. Because so, Lord, Yahweh Hashem Yahshai have helped me and comforted me. See? So, since we are talking about mercy, let's go to Micah 7. This is my favorite, man. He say, Micah 7 and 8, say, who is a power like unto thee that pardon iniquity and passes by the transgression of the remnant of his heritage, he retain not his anger forever because he delight in mercy. See? Because he delight in mercy. That's where you get the balance in judgment. There is mercy and lust in judgment. When you talk about judgment, people think only about the last of Yahweh Hashem Yahshai. In judgment, you have also planters' mercy, or what you call the sure mercy of David. See? The sure mercy of David. See? That's the balance in judgment. Say, he will turn again, he will have compassion on us, he will subdue our iniquity, and so will cast all your sin into the depths of the sea. So will perform the truth in Jacob and have mercy to Abraham and his seed, which thou have sworn unto your father from the day of old. So all praise to Yahweh Hashem Yahshai. So we praise that, amen, we are found worthy, man, to receive that crown of salvation, man, to receive incorruptible body, to receive the heavenly tabernacle, man, to be in the new covenant, in the first round, go. So we praise this to Yahweh Hashem Yahshai and Babakasha, Babakasha, Babakasha. Amen.